Hi everyone, hope all of you are doing fine. So today I'm going to make some very lovely pork curry with coconut gravy and potatoes. So it's the pork rib curry. So stay tuned, watch and enjoy, and also subscribe to my YouTube channel for more lovely videos and recipes. Take care. Bye. Alright everyone, so yeah, I've got about 500 grams of pork ribs with a little bit of water. So 2 cups of water, and I put a little bit of fenugreek seeds, 1 teaspoon, and season it with a little bit of salt. So this is my rice cooker, so I'm just boiling it in that water. So I'll be boiling it just until this pinkish raw coloration goes away and it becomes sort of, you know, this sort of a color all through, all in all, you know, on all sides. And then I will strain off the water. If you like that pork fat and the pork stock, you can, you know, use this water as gravy, but I might drain majority of the water just to get rid of that extra unwanted pork fat. But that fat does have flavor, but I'm just not a fan of it, so it's up to your personal preference. Here are some ingredients for the gravy. So I've got 1 chicken stock cube, 3 dried red chilies, 1 potato, 1 onion, and 165 ml of coconut milk. I'm gonna chop the onion, the potato, and the chilies. So there we are, just sliced up the onions. And there we are, chopped up the potato and also the dried red chili. Next, you can heat a pan with a little bit of oil or ghee. So I'm just heating up some ghee here. The flavors will be different depending on what sort of oil you use or whether you use ghee. So I want that nice, lovely, rich flavor because I'm throwing away this pork fat water anyway. So I want to add extra flavor. So I'm just adding a little bit of ghee. The pork pieces are immersed nicely in water. That raw discoloration is gone. So I'm just going to strain this water off. So that's all the fatty water from the pork. So there we are. It's looking nice and lovely. It's not fully cooked yet. We'll be combining it with the gravy and cooking it further. So I'm just going to add those ingredients into this pan. Goes the onion, potato, red chilies, and the chicken stock cube. I'm just going to crush it and put it in. So we're just combining it nicely together. Now from my spice box, I'm just going to add in a few spices. So I'm going to season it with a little bit of salt. We can even season it with a little bit of cracked pepper as well. Little bit of chili powder, that's up to how spicy you want it. So this is a mixture of Kashmiri and the spicy chili powder. I just mix them up together so it gives the color and the spice. I'm going to add in about 2 teaspoons of coriander powder, a little bit of fennel, and 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric, so maybe 1 teaspoon of fennel seeds, and also 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala. I'm seasoning it with salt and adding a little bit of chili powder, 2 teaspoons of coriander powder, 1 teaspoon of fennel seeds, 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala, and 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric. So mix it nicely until the onion fries up and becomes nice and golden brown. Look at this beautiful sight, everyone. Onion, potato, red chili with the masala nicely taking shape. Once the onions turn into this nice brown caramelized color, the golden brown color, I'm going to add in 1 tablespoon of ginger garlic paste. Once the raw smell's gone, I'm going to take this and put this along with the pork. And into that, I'm going to put about 1.5 cups of water and cook it nicely until the potato is nicely boiled and the pork is nicely cooked. So there we are. It's looking nice and lovely. So I'm just going to cook it. I put the timer for about 20 to 25 minutes. So about 25 minutes. So it should be ready in that time. Pork fat stuck on there, but look at it, everyone. Nice and colorful, isn't it? So let it boil away, everyone. So after 25 minutes, I just want to check this. So I'm taking the lid off. Yes, the gravy, it's kind of semi-dry at the moment because, you know, there's very little gravy left. So it's up to you, you know, how much seasoning you have put in and how much gravy you want. And the other main thing is also to make sure that the potato is nicely cooked. This is perfect. See, it's not that mushy, but at the same time it's nicely boiled and cooked. Nice and lovely. It's got that lovely texture to it. So yeah, looks like it's done. Isn't it? It's hard to see, you know, while looking through the camera what's happening. So let me just show you guys. I don't know if you can see, but yeah, the potato is basically nicely cooked. I don't want to be cooking it any further. Oh my god, melt in the mouth. Woo-hoo! It's like infused with the flavors of the masala. Oh, it's super. Super means super. It's really not bland or anything. It's got that lovely kick of the masala. Next, we can go ahead and put the 165 ml of coconut milk into that. There we are. And then give it all a good mix around. So instantly the gravy will become nice and rich with that coconut flavor. Look at this. See, even the color will change. You can even skip that step, you know. This is just an extra step to give it that nice, lovely coconut flavor for the gravy. And that's basically it, everyone. Once it starts bubbling away, you can take it off the heat and plate it up. Yeah, so here I've got some fenugreek and ghee rice that I made. So you can see the fenugreek seeds. So it's nice, lovely, steamy and flavorsome. That ghee gives it that nice, lovely smell. So I'm going to have the dish along with this nice, simple rice. Just went ahead and plated the rice. So it's nice and lovely. And we can put the curry. So there's our lovely pork rib curry with potatoes in coconut gravy. So look at this. Lovely ribs or riblets. So my son is talking about Macca's Happy Meal. Even if I cook at home, see, such delicious food I've cooked, and he still wants Macca's Happy Meal. This is what makes me irritated at times, you know. But anyway, let's focus on our rib curry.
Right now it's raining.
Is it raining? Make it look a bit more pretty. So do check for taste and make sure you're happy with the seasoning and everything. And yeah, apart from that, here it is, everyone. Nice and lovely, yummy dish. It goes so well with just this plain steamy ghee rice. Now it's my favorite part of the show, taste time, Indian style using hands. So cheers! Oh my god, look at this pork. It's so juicy! I'm not kidding y'all, it's seriously so juicy. Oh my god. It's just falling off the bone. And that masala and that coconut richness. Oof. Super. Oh, I'm not a messy eater. What am I doing in front of camera? I'm just getting carried away, you know. That intensity of the flavors is just so lovely. It's just taking me to another world. So I'm going to dig in. I'm just inspiring you guys, you know, to get into your kitchen and start cooking this and eating it up. You'll love it. You'll enjoy it, you know. It's like we get so much satisfaction feeling when we eat some warm, homey, comfort food, isn't it? Yeah.
You got that yummy, yum, that yummy, yum, that yummy, yummy. Yeah, you got that yummy, yum, that yummy, yum, that yummy, yummy.
And apart from that, here it is, everyone, our lovely pork rib curry with coconut gravy and potatoes is ready. Subscribe to my YouTube channel for more lovely videos and recipes. Take care. Enjoy. Bye. Hope all of you enjoyed this video. Subscribe to my YouTube channel for more lovely videos and recipes. Take care. Bye.